You're now at the lab with Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory. My name is Brienne Severoli, and this week at the lab, a heart of golf. To any golfers listening, stick with us. Our story begins with something closer to everyone's heart, and that is the human heart itself. When it comes to the heart, there are many mysteries. One in particular dates back centuries. It was stumbled on by none other than Leonardo da Vinci. About 500 years ago, Da Vinci noticed a cobblestone-like pattern of muscles lining the inside wall of the heart. And for 500 years, nobody knew why they were arranged like this, until now.
Let me put it this way, they reduced the odds for heart disease.
That's Hannah Meyer, an assistant professor at Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory. Meyer took a holistic view to researching heart disease. She compared the organ's genetic makeup with its phenotype, how it looks and behaves.
I was very interested in organ function as a whole. Can we use the genetics and these phenotypes that we can extract to understand more about the physiology of an organ, both in health and disease? So we teamed up with bioengineers and with clinical researchers to try and understand a small phenotype in the heart from the perspective of how does it influence the function of the heart.
Using special software, Meyer and her colleagues analyzed the clinical data of 25,000 patients in the UK Biobank. From here, the team was able to see how the heart wall's cobblestone-like muscles, called trabeculae, work and develop. And guess what? It's a lot like a golf ball turned inside out. If you're a golfer, you might know that the dimples on the ball reduce air resistance, helping it travel farther. Trabeculae cut down on fluid resistance. Hearts with the right kind of muscle pattern are able to pump blood with less resistance. Their trabeculae branch out in a shape resembling that of the heart. And Meyer's team found that patients who have this going on are at lower risk of heart failure. Meyer has since turned her data-driven research to cancer.
Every piece of software that I've developed is on an open platform. There's more than 20,000 people who've downloaded it.
And that means that thanks to her, we may now soon have a better understanding of why many other organs look the way they do. Eat your heart out, Da Vinci. Thanks for listening to At the Lab. Please subscribe wherever you get your podcasts and visit us at cshl.edu for more fascinating science stories like this one. For Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory, I'm Brienne Severoli, and I'll see you next time at the lab.